Shalom, shalom. First off, I want to give all praises to YAHAWAH, Bahashem, YHWH, Bahashem, Racha, Kodash, Barakat YAHAWAH, and Barakat YHWH. YAHAWAH is the true name of the Heavenly Father, and YHWH is the true name of the Heavenly Father's Son, the Son of YAHAWAH. I want to give double honors to the apostles and elders, a great millstone, and peace and blessings goes to the hopeful elect, your brothers that are going out in the highways and byways, pushing his word in truth and sincerity. I'm the brother Azaria from the LA camp, and just try to make a quick video in how the Lord hates. All right, because in the world, they think that the Lord's all about love. You know, he loves. That's all they talk about in churches. They teach about the love. But what they forget to mention and to teach about is how the things that he hates. All right. They forget to mention that the Lord hates, man. All right. You know, first and foremost, he hates Esau, like it's mentioned in Malachi 1. All right. And he hates wickedness, man. The Lord hates wickedness. Like it says, let's bring that out real quick. Let's see, I think it's 12. All right. Cause another thing they say in church is that the Lord hates the sin, but not the sinner, right? But this is what the Bible says, all right? Where it says, Ecclesiastes, Sirach 12 and 6. It says, for the Most High hated sinners and will repay vengeance unto the ungodly and keepeth them against the mighty day of their punishment. So you see, the Most High hated sinners, all right? He hates people that, he hates the ones that break his law, statutes, commandments, man, which it goes to show that the Lord hates his, the two-thirds of his people right now, all right? Because they're breaking his law, statutes, commandments, man. Our people are sinners, and they refuse to repent, all right? Therefore, the Lord's not with them, man, all right? The Lord hates two-thirds of his people, all right? Because they are sinners, like we just bring out, like we just brought out in Sirach 12 and 6, all right? So let's go back to Proverbs 6 and 16, all right? It says, these six things do what the Lord hate. Yeah, seven are an abomination unto him. All right, there's six things that the Lord hates, and the seventh is an abomination unto him, right? It says, a proud look. All right, and a lot of our people are proud, all right? And they have that. They have, our people are proud, man. You know, man and woman from the southern and northern tribe, man. Southern and northern kingdom. All right, all the tribes, you have wicked of our people that are proud, all right? Proud about what they have. Proud about how successful they are in society or what they do, all right? Not knowing that this is one of the things that the Lord hates, man, all right? It's a proud look, okay? It says, a proud look, a lying tongue, and a hands that shed innocent blood, all right? And these are the things that the Lord hates. It says, a lying tongue and hands that shed innocent blood, all right? And that's our people, all right? You know, Esau as well. Esau sheds innocent blood. Esau is proud. Esau lies, but I'm going into how our people are the same, man. You know, our people are proud. Our people have a lying tongue. Our people are shed innocent blood. All right, I saw a video on Wall Street how this these two Jakes. One of the Jake got mad that his friend, they were arguing. These two guys were arguing about one of the guys' friend. All right, because one of the guys' friend did something to the other guy, and he got all mad, right? And the guy that got mad, he just put out his gun and shot him, man. Just shot the Jake. The guy he shot had nothing to do with what he was mad about, but he just shot him because he said something, man, to him. You know? And Jake's like that, guess what? YHWH hates, man. Cause they're so quick to shed innocent blood, man. You have a lot of our Jakes in the hood that'll kill you over a color, man. You don't even have to be part of the gang. All right, you don't even have to be part of the gang. You just wear the color, right? And Jake will kill you over that, man. All right, and these are the things that YHWH hates, man. You know, a proud look, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood. Verse 18, it says, "And heart that deviseth wicked imaginations, feet that be swift into running to mischief." You know, yeah, Jake that will be so quick to sin, man, without thinking about it. You know, a woman that has a husband, right, is messing with, you know, Jake will mess with the woman that has a husband without thinking about it, man. They'll just do it, you know, because in this world they push that in this society. They push committing adultery is okay, but it's not okay with the Most High, because if you commit adultery, that's what? That's punishable by death, man. All right, but Jake don't think of the consequences, man. They don't think that that they're gonna get punished for the sins that they've committed, man. But like it says in Ecclesiastes 12:6, for the Most High hateth sinners, and will repay vengeance unto the ungodly, and keepeth them against the mighty day of their punishment. So just because you don't get punished for committing adultery at that moment, all right, don't mean you're not gonna get punished for it, man. All right, the Lord is just keeping you until the day that he decides to punish you, man. All right. So let's go to back in Proverbs 6:18. It says, a heart that devises wicked imaginations, feet that be swift into running to mischief, a false witness that speaketh lies, and he that soweth discord among brethren. All right. My son, keep thy father's commandments and forsake not the law of thy mother. All right. And that's what and this is what we got to do. And that's my son. Keep thy father's commandments. Right. Jake don't honor their parents. Jake be dishonoring their parents, not doing what their parents do. They'll curse out their parents. They'll hit their parents. You know, Jake don't know how to honor their father or their mother, man. And this is something that this is a law that we have to keep. This is one of the 10 commandments. It's to keep to honor our father and our mother. All right. All right. So let's bring out one more scripture and I'll close. I didn't want to make it this long, but says I'll read Malachi 1:1. All right. It says, the burden of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi. I have loved you, saith the Lord. Yet ye say, wherein has thou loved us? All right. And that's the attitude of Jake. All right. The Lord loves us. All right. But Jake have that mentality. Well, the Lord don't love us. We're look at the condition we are in today. We're all constantly getting shot. We're constantly in poverty. We're constantly going through it, not understanding why these things are happening to them, man. All right, we're in the condition that we are in today. All right, we had to serve slavery because what? We broke the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. We angered the Most High. Remember what Moses told you in the wilderness, man. All right, that what the Lord had Moses tell his people Israel in the wilderness. All right, if you keep my law, statutes, and commandments, I will bless you. But if you break them, I will curse you. And we are cursed. We are cursed, man. All right. So let's read that again. It says, I have loved you, saith the Lord. And this is love. All right. The Lord, this by the Lord having this happen to his people, he's showing his people love. All right. Because like it says in Hebrews, the whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth, man. All right. So it says, I have loved you, saith the Lord. Yet ye say, wherein hast thou loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother, saith the Lord? Yeah, I love Jacob. Yeah, the Lord loved Jacob. He chose Jacob, man. That's why he had Jacob steal Esau's birthright and his blessing from Isaac. All right, that Isaac was going to give Esau, man. All right, he had Jacob supplanted. That's what if the Hebrew word is Yaquab, which means supplant. All right, Jacob supplanted his father by pretending he was Esau to take his birthright. And he supplanted Esau by selling him a red pottage, all right, that would, you know, red pottage, and he supplanted him by, I'll give you this red pottage, this undercooked meat, I'll give you this undercooked meat if you give me your birthright. Here it is. Then you know Esau, you know the story. Esau gave Jacob his birthright, man. All right, and it was all through the Spirit because the Lord chose Jacob and not Esau, because the Lord loved Jacob, and it says what? And I hated Esau. All right. And the Lord hated Esau. That's why he allowed Jacob to steal his, supplant him from his birth, both of his birthrights, man. All right. So it says, and I hated Esau and laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness. All right. So these are just two scriptures that goes to show you. Well, I brought out three. All right. These are just three scriptures that, you know, that are brought out through the Spirit, that how it shows that the Lord hates, man. All right, he's not all about love. He loves, but he shows you that tough love. All right, it's not the love that what the church tells you. All right, he loves you by blessing you, by giving you riches, by giving you your heart's desires, which we are gonna get our heart's desires. We are gonna get blessed. We are gonna be rich. But that's not now. That's not in this time, because you have to understand we're in Esau's rulership, man. All right, and we're going through our chastisement, man. All right, we're going through our punishment. We're still serving our punishment. All right, we're gonna get blessed, and we're gonna get blessed. We're gonna get rich when the Lord takes down Esau and put an end to his wicked society and set up his kingdom in righteousness, man. If you're showing repentance, if you're part of the elect, right? If you're part of the elect, the elect are partakers of his suffering. If you're partakers of his suffering, we're gonna be joint heirs in his kingdom, man. So we are gonna get blessed. All right, that's just not now. All right, the Lord shows us by how he loves us by chastening us, man. All right, you can't say that the Lord hates. You can't say that the Lord hates because he hates. You can't just get into how he's all about love because he's not all about love. He hates, man. But the love that he shows, like I said, is that tough love. All right. Remember, he's shown his own only begotten son that tough love, man. He chastised his only begotten son. All right. But he loved his son, YHWH, man. All right. Remember what he told Peter. All right. That this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. All right. Because YHWH, you got to think about it. YHWH, when he was on earth, he went through hell, man. All right. He caught it. All right. He had to bear his cross. All right. And we being servants of YHWH, YHWH, we have to bear ours, man. All right. The Lord shows us that he loves us by putting hell on us. All right. Like it says in Hebrews. So with that, I hope you brothers edified. I want to give all praises to YHWH, Bahashem, YHWH, Bahashem, Racha, Kadash. Till next time, I want to say Shalom.